You've been diagnosed with colorectal cancer, or maybe you've just finished treatment. How you keep the cancer from returning. In this video, I'm going to give you 10 tips that will give you the best chances to stay cancer-free for years to come. There are no guarantees that the cancer will stay away, but these tips will give you a fighting chance. What's my connection to all of this? My name is Jelena, and I was diagnosed with stage 3 colorectal cancer in 2016 at the age of 34. I, of course, dug deep into some research on what I could do to prevent my cancer from recurring after I finished treatment. Because after you've been through radiation, two different types of chemotherapy, and a 5.5 hour long surgery to cut all that cancer out of your body, you want to do all that you can to keep that monster from returning. It's now been 5.5 years since I finished treatment, and I've been cancer-free ever since, so that's got to be worth something. 80% of recurrences happen within the first 2 to 3 years after you finish treatment. So making it 5.5 means that my chances of the cancer recurring are about the same as the chances of your average 40-year-old woman being diagnosed with cancer. So my odds are looking pretty good now. Now let's dive into those tips that will give you the best chances to keep your cancer from recurring. Tip number one. Follow your doctor's recommendations as to whether or not adjuvant chemotherapy is best for your case. Adjuvant chemotherapy is chemo that is done after you complete surgery. It will typically be recommended if your cancer has spread to lymph nodes, other organs, or if the cancer is rated as a T3. The T staging describes the depth that the tumor has invaded the colon or rectum wall. The reason that chemotherapy may be recommended, even though it appears as though the tumor and all the affected lymph nodes have been removed, is because there's a chance that microscopic cells could be left behind. It's impossible for a surgeon to see these while they're operating on you, and they're so small that a CT scan won't even pick them up. Those cells can then begin multiplying again, but the chemotherapy can kill those microscopic cells to make sure that you are completely rid of cancer. Tip number two. Stay or get physically active. Plenty of research has shown that participating in regular physical activity not only reduces your risk of a colorectal cancer recurrence, but also lowers your chances of dying from it. Physical activity can also help you better deal with post-treatment fatigue and improve your quality of life. Tip number three, reduce alcohol use. The link between alcohol use and cancer recurrence isn't known, but we do know that heavy alcohol use increases your risk of being diagnosed with colorectal cancer in the first place. So reducing your alcohol use should reduce your risk of your cancer recurring. Tip number four, drink 4 cups of coffee a day. If you can tolerate coffee, drink up. Studies have shown that drinking 4 cups of coffee per day can reduce your chance of a cancer recurrence by 42%. That's huge. Even 2 to 3 cups a day will give you a moderate reduction in your chances of a recurrence. While 1 cup or less, non-herbal tea or decaffeinated coffee give you no benefits. I've put the link in the description to this study so that you can read more about it yourself. Tip number five, quit smoking. If you smoke, you're more likely to die from your cancer than if you had quit. I'm sure you're all familiar with the general risks and health issues that smoking can cause, so quit if you want a better quality of life and want to live longer. Tip number six, eat a diet low in red meat. It's been proven that eating a diet high in red and processed meats increases your chances of being diagnosed with colorectal cancer. So it makes sense that decreasing your consumption of these will also decrease your risk of a recurrence. Tip number seven, eat a couple of servings of tree nuts weekly. It's been proven that people who consume 2 1-ounce servings of tree nuts weekly have a 42% improvement in disease-free survival. Examples of tree nuts are walnuts, cashews, almonds, pistachios, hazelnuts, pecans, Brazil nuts, and macadamia nuts. I had never heard of this until one of my viewers, Noelle, commented on one of my latest videos about eating walnuts for digestive health. So I looked into it a little bit and discovered the link between eating tree nuts weekly and it lowering your risk of a recurrence. So thank you, Noelle. And if you're questioning this tip, I've got links in the description below of multiple articles from legit sources like Dana-Farber and the Mayo Clinic supporting this research. Tip number eight, Make sure you're following your doctor's follow-up schedule, which will include blood work for your CEA, colonoscopy, and CT scans. Following your oncologist's recommended follow-up schedule won't necessarily prevent your cancer from recurring, but if it does recur, it will ensure that it will be caught in an earlier stage, which means it'll be more treatable. For me, my first year follow-up schedule was going in to have my blood work checked every 3 months for the CEA, CT scans every 6 months, and a colonoscopy 1 year from my surgery date. After I made it the first year without my cancer recurring, my oncologist moved my CT scans to just once a year, but still had me come in every 3 months to have my CEA checked since I was diagnosed at such a young age. Now that I'm more than 5 years out from treatment, I just go in once a year to see my oncologist to have my CEA checked. I also go in for regular colonoscopies, which for me right now is once every 3 years. Tip number 9, eat a diet high in plant-based foods and fiber. Eating a high-fiber diet that includes a lot of plant-based foods lowers your risk for being diagnosed with colorectal cancer because it improves your bowel health. So it makes sense that eating this type of diet after you finish treatment will do the same in lowering your risk for being diagnosed with a recurrence. And finally, tip number 10, taking low-dose aspirin. Recent studies have shown that taking a low-dose aspirin daily can reduce your chance of a cancer recurrence in patients that are at a low risk of stomach bleeding. Research is still happening to determine what the safest dosage is of this to minimize side effects. So if you're considering this option, please talk with your doctor before starting to take aspirin daily. Are there any tips that you follow that I didn't cover? Let me know in the comments below. These tips are just a starting point. Don't feel pressure to follow every single one of them word for word every single day. Every little bit that you do will help increase your chances to prevent your cancer from recurring. But if you're unlucky enough that it does, following these tips will have made your body stronger and healthier and better prepared to deal with the new treatment plan ahead. Wishing you the best of health, and thanks for watching.